why do you want to be a champion? Or what do you want to accomplish? Why are you training? And they will, if a guy will get up and he will say, well, I want to train because I think that if I get muscular and, you know, I feel like I'm getting the kind of definition, then I maybe can enter a bodybuilding competition. I said, sit down. I said, if you think this way, you're going to be a loser. You're never going to make it because there's no maybe. You got to get up and say, I want to be a champion. And I do whatever it takes, the amount of hours it takes, the posing, the this, the that, the visualization, looking at training footage, looking at motivational books, reading this, reading, whatever it takes, I would do. That's the answer I want to hear from you. You can detect right away those that are going to be shaky and that will fall behind and they will not go all the way, and those that are very hungry. And that hunger you have to develop because you have to create a goal for yourself, whatever that may be, a short-term goal and a long-term goal. And you got to go after that. And if you do not see it, and if you do not believe it, who else will? The body is very important, but the mind is more important than the body.
The body is not used to maybe the 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th rep with a certain weight. So that makes the body grow then, going through this pain barrier, experiencing pain in your muscles and aching, and just then go on and go on and go on. And this last two or three or four repetitions, that's what makes actually the muscle then grow. And that divides then one from a champion and one from not being a champion. If you can go through this pain barrier, you make it to be a champion. If you can't go through, forget it. And that's what most people lack, is in this, having the guts to go in and just say, I go through and I don't care what happens. You know, it aches, and if I fall down, I have no fear of fainting in a gym, because I know it could happen. I threw up many times while I was working out, but it doesn't matter because it's all worth it.
And we see battles. We have our own battles, but we see the battles that the enemy is bringing to other people. Let me give you a point. Battles will always present themselves. It will always come. We'll always have battles. If that's not the positive, feel-good message you're looking for, here it comes. You can overcome. Jesus Christ gave us victory over sin. He gave us victory over the works of the enemy. That doesn't mean that the enemy doesn't still attack. Doesn't mean we don't live in a fallen world. Of course we do. But every battle that you face, you learn from, and you can take someone from that place. You can help someone else, because you've gone through a battle, you can help them through it as well. A battle will always represent itself. They will always come forth. But you can come forth in victory. Listen, you don't have to be a victim. You can be a victor. Everyone can fall victim. We can fall victim at times. But we don't stay in a victim mentality, a victim lifestyle. We are victors. We're more than victors. And we can take that and we can overcome any battle that comes our way.
Be slaves. So today, although we're slaves, we're going to act like we're free. And one day, our children will be free. If the slaves would have just said, we quit, we give up, we would have died in the middle passage. But some slaves said, I don't care what we go through, we're going to survive this. 400 years of slavery, we're going to get through this. And you can't get through it. 1825. You can't get through a writing class, and you got tutor after tutor, resource after resource. The problem is, you ain't never felt no pain before. You're soft. It's a soft generation. You quit on everything. Our people did not quit. Harriet Tubman not only made it, she went back and got some more. She said, you know what? I made it, but I'm going to walk all, listen to me, shh, not ride the bus. I'm going to walk all the way back down to the south to get some more. And you quitting on 1825.
You used to fit right here. I'd hold you up and say to your mother, this kid's going to be the best kid in the world. This kid's going to be somebody better than anybody ever knew. And you grew up good and wonderful. It was great just watching. Every day was like a privilege. Then the time come for you to be your own man and take on the world, and you did. But somewhere along the line, you changed. You stopped being you. You let people stick a finger in your face and tell you you're no good. And when things got hard, you started looking for something to blame, like a big shadow. Let me tell you something you already know. The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you gotta be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you wanna be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that.
So what do you do when you fall down? Get back up. Everybody knows to get back up, because if I start walking, I'm not gonna get anywhere. But I tell you, there are some times in life where you fall down and you feel like you don't have the strength to get back up. Do you think you have hope? Because I tell you, I'm down here, face down, and I have no arms, no legs. It should be impossible for me to get back up, but it's not. You see, I will try 100 times to get up, and if I fail 100 times, if I fail and I give up, do you think that I'm ever going to get up? No. But if I fail, I try again, and again, and again. But I just want you to know that it's not the end. It matters how you're going to finish. Are you going to finish strong? And you will find that strength to get back up like this.
And the problem with most of you, you never felt no pain before. Y'all spoiled. Y'all spoiled. Some of y'all spoiled. Just bottom line, your parents have done everything for you. You never had to do nothing for yourself. You're spoiled. We're going to keep it real tonight. Some of you are spoiled brats. Every time you ever got in trouble, somebody in your house got you out of it. Every time you've done something you're not supposed to do, people say, Eric, your mother's a tyrant. You're right. She kicked me out. You're right. She's mean, but she developed a man because she put me out there and said, you're going to have to grow up. And some of you have never learned to grow up. And so every time something get hard, you quit, you call mama. I dare you to take a little pain. I dare you. I dare you not to go home. Somebody said, I don't go home. I feel bad. Go through it. You ain't going to die. At the end of pain is success. You're not going to die because you're feeling a little pain. I'm not eating like I eat at home. That's why you're about to go to the next level, because if you keep eating like you ate at home, you'll keep being a boy or a girl. It's time to become man, woman. Watch this. There was a commercial. Emmitt Smith had won his first Super Bowl, and he had this commercial when he was lifting weights. I don't know if you saw the commercial when he was lifting, and he said, Emmitt said, you know what? I won the Super Bowl so I can rest now. He was doing his bench press. So he said, I won the Super Bowl so I can rest now. So he throws up about 325, boom. And he rests for about 2 seconds. And he, boom, boom, boom. Did you see that? He'd already won a Super Bowl. He said, I think I'm gonna take a rest. And he rests for how long? 1 second. Most of you won't be successful because when you're studying and you get tired, you quit. And I'm here to tell you today, somebody came to my office the other day crying. I said, look, don't cry to give up. Cry to keep going. Don't cry to quit. You already in pain. You already hurt. Get a reward from it. Don't go to sleep until you succeed. Listen to me. I'm here to tell you today that you can come here. You can jump up. You can do flips. You can be excited when we give away money. But listen to me. You will never be successful until I don't have to give you a dime to do what you do. You won't be successful until you say, I don't need that money. Because I got it.
The pain of your past will determine your passion for the future. The Word of God says, those who have been forgiven much will love much. Those who have been forgiven much will love much. Well, I will also add that those who have overcome a lot can help other people overcome. If you have a passion for something, here's the key. If you have a passion, maybe it's a political passion, maybe it's a civil rights passion, maybe it's a passion for the church, maybe it's a passion for people, maybe it's a passion for whatever that movement is that you're really passionate about. Does it stem because you're just jumping on a bandwagon, or is it because of something you've overcome in the past? I've overcome death of loved ones. I've overcome divorce. I've overcome different church beliefs and different things I've had to overcome in the past, different pains I've had to overcome, and so I'm able to take other people through them. I recognized that, and what did I do? I didn't just go in with passion. I went in with knowledge. I took my coaching certification. I went and got my master's degree in temperament therapy, and I did the things that I had to do so I could properly bring people from pain into a place of fulfillment, a place of hope, a place of achieving things. What about you? What is it that's been in your past that you've overcome that is a passion for you today? Begin to look at that. Begin to look at that, because many times that pain will try to still regurgitate, come back into your life because you haven't truly overcome it by having a passion towards helping. Sometimes pain will not leave until you take other people through it, until you take what you've learned and actually let it grow forth in a place of hope for someone else. Not everyone's going to be a counselor, not everyone's going to be a life coach, but you have to let things you've overcome. And is it giving you a passion to help other people? Sometimes it's just being a voice. Sometimes it's just being an ear to hear.
Listen to me. Pain is temporary. It may last for a minute, or an hour, or a day, or even a year. But eventually, it will subside. And something else will take its place. If I quit, however, it will last forever.